20 Morning Muri Essence Sweet children, you are now entering new relationships. Therefore, forget all your relationships here that are based on karmic bondage and make effort to become karmatit. Question: Which children does the father praise? To which children does he give the most love? Answer: Baba sings praise of his poor children. This poverty is so wonderful. Don't become greedy, but remain comfortable. Just eat two chapatis. Poor children remember the father with a lot of love. Baba is pleased to see the uneducated children because they don't have to make effort to forget what they have studied. Om Shanti. The father doesn't need to tell you children every day to consider yourselves to be souls. May you be souls conscious means may you remain in the awareness of being bodiless. These words mean the same thing. The father says, consider yourself to be soul. A part of 84 births is recorded in each of your souls. You souls take bodies, play your parts, and then your bodies perish. Souls are imperishable. It is only now that you children receive this knowledge. No one else knows about these things. The father says, now try to remember the father as much as possible. When you are busy in your business, you don't have that much remembrance. Stay at home with your family, but live as pure as lotus flower and remember me as much as possible. It isn't that you only have to sit here for meditation that is specially conducted. The words specially conducted meditation are wrong. In fact, it is just remembrance. No matter where you are sitting, remember the father. Many storms of Maya will come. Some will remember one thing and other will remember something else. Storms will definitely come. Therefore, at that time, you have to be chase them away so that they don't come. Even whilst you sit here, Maya continue to harass you a great deal. When you take birth, your intellects are drawn to your bondage. At first, your souls are free from bondage. When you take birth, your intellects are drawn to your parents. Their partner is adopted. Things that weren't there before now start to appear in front of you. Then children are born and remembrance of them increasing. All of them now too have to be forgotten. Only the one father must be remembered. This is why the father is praised. He is your mother and your father, etc. He is everything to you. Remember him alone. Everything he gives you for the future is new. He also sends you into new relationships. There will be relationships there too. It isn't that there will be annihilation. You shed your bodies and take others. Those who have been very good will definitely take birth in an elevated family. You are studying now for your future 21 births. Your studies will end and your reward will start. In a school, they study and are then transferred. You too are going to be transferred. first to the land of peace and then to the land of happiness, means Shanti Dham and Sukh Dham. You will be liberated from this dirty world. This is called hell. The golden age is called heaven. Human beings here are in total darkness. The wealthy think that this is heaven for them here. Heaven exists in the new world. This old world is going to be destroyed. Those who reach their karmatit stage will not have to be experienced punishment in the realm of Dharmaraj. There will be no punishment in heaven. There, even the worms you enter are like palaces. There is no question of sorrow there. Here, a worm is like a jail, and therefore punishment is experienced. Just remember how many times you have become residents of heaven, and you will remember the whole cycle. Just this one aspect is worth hundreds of thousands of rupees. When you forget this and become body conscious, Maya causes you a great loss. This is the effort you must make. No one can claim a high status without making effort. Some say, Baba, I am uneducated. Or Baba, I don't know anything. Baba then becomes very happy because everything you have studied so far has to be forgotten here. What you studied was just for a short time in order for you to earn your livelihood, etc. You know that everything is now going to be destroyed. Remember the father as much as possible and eat a piece of chapatis in a great happiness. The poverty of this time is wonderful. Don't become greedy, but simply eat a piece of chapati in comfort. Nowadays, there is even a shortage of grain. Gradually, you won't even be able to obtain sugar. It isn't that because you are doing God's service, the government will give you everything. They don't know anything. Yes, your children are told to explain to the government that all of us are going to our parents' home together. Baba has to send Toli to some children. Here, they very clearly say, no, we haven't got any. Perhaps they would give a little to those in desperate circumstances. Just as someone wealthy would give a handful to a fakir. Fakir means religious wandering ascetic. Poor ones would only give a little. Sugar, etc. can be brought here, but the yoke of your children then decreases because you don't stay in remembrance but become body conscious. You accomplish nothing. This task will not be accomplished by studying as much as through yoke. This is very little yoke. Maya make you forget to have remembrance. She catches hold of the powerful ones very strongly. Even very good and first class children have bad omens over them. The main reason for their having bad omens in their lack of yoga. Because of bad omens, some children become trapped in someone name and form. This destination is very high. If you really do want to reach your true destination, you have to stay in remembrance. The father says, knowledge is better than trance, but remembrance is better than knowledge. What the father told? नॉलेज इज बेटर देन ट्रांस बट रिमेम्बरेंस इज बेटर देन नॉलेज. व्हेन यू गो इनटू ट्रांस टू मच द एविल स्पिरिट्स ऑफ माया एंटर यू. मैनी गो इनटू ट्रांस अननेसेसरली. They speak of so many things. They shouldn't be trusted. Knowledge is received from Babas purely. The father continues to warn you that trance is of no use. There is a lot of interferences of Maya in that. There is also arrogance. Everyone continues to receive this knowledge. It is Shiv Baba who gives you this knowledge. Mamma too used to receive knowledge here. That can also be called Manmana Bhava. Remember the father and imbibe divine virtues. Check yourself to see whether you are imbibing divine virtues. It is here that divine virtues have to be imbibed. You can see that someone's stage is first class. One moment that he does everything in great happiness and that after an hour the evil spirit of anger comes and everything is then finished. Then he becomes aware that he made a mistake and he reforms himself. Some of you are like an hour clock. Baba has many children like that. One moment they are so sweet that Baba would even say that he will sacrifice himself to such children. Then, after an hour, they become upset about one thing or another. Anger comes and everything you had earned up to then is destroyed. One moment, there is an income accumulated and the next moment, there is a loss. Everything depends on remembrance. Knowledge is very easy. Even a small child can explain it. However, they have to understand me accurately. Who am I and what I am? Little children are unable to remember me whilst considering themselves to be souls. When someone is about to die, he is told to remember God. But because he doesn't know him accurately, he would be unable to remember him accurately. Neither can anyone return home yet, nor can anyone's sins be absolved by that. From the beginning, rishis and munis have been saying that they don't know the creator or creation. At the beginning, they were satoguni. At least, how could their present tamopradhan intellects understand this? The father says, even Lakshmi and Narayan don't know me. If the king and queen don't know, how could their subjects know? No one knows me. At present, only you children know me. Amongst you too, there are some who knows me accurately. Some says, Baba, I forget you many times again and again. The father says, wherever you go, simply remember the father. The income you earn from this is so huge. You become free from illness for 21 births. You must become introspective to remember such a father. However, Maya makes you forget him and bring storms. Here, you have to become introspective and churn the ocean of knowledge. It is only now that you have to churn the ocean of knowledge. This is the confluence age in which you become the most elevated human being of all. Your children must have seen the wonder of how. In this same family, the husband says that he belongs to the confluence age and his half partner and children say that they belong to the iron age. There is so much differences. The things that the father explains are very subtle and refined. Even whilst you live at home with your family, you must keep the fact in your intellect that you are making effort to become a flower. This is a matter of experience. You have to make this practical effort. Effort just lies in remembrance. In the same home, one would be a swan and the other one a stone. Some couples are first class. They never have any thought of vice. They live together and still remain pure. They show how courageous they are. Therefore, they will receive such a high status. There are many such children. Some beat others and quarrel with them for vice. Your stage should be such that you don't even have the slightest thought of becoming impure. The father continues to advise you for every situation. You know that you will become Sri Lakshmi or Sri Narayan by following the direction of Sri Sri, means elevated. In the golden age, you are number one elevated. In the silver age, there are 2 degrees less. You children receive this knowledge at this time. The law for this gathering of God is that only those who value the jewels of knowledge and how and who never yawn should sit in the front. Some children sit in front of the father and then continue to yawn or even nod off. They should go and sit at the back. This is God's gathering of His children. In spite of that, some teachers still bring such people here. You are receiving wealth from the Father. Each verses is worth hundreds of thousands of rupees. You know that it is only at the confluence age that you are given this knowledge. You say, Baba, we have come once again to claim our unlimited inheritance. Baba repeatedly says to you, sweetest children, this world is dirty. You must have unlimited disinterest in it. The father says, whatever you see now in this world will not exist tomorrow. There will be no name or trace of temples, etc. There in heaven, there is no need for anyone to visit ancient things. Here, so much value is placed on ancient things. In fact, nothing apart from the father has any value. The father says, if I didn't come, how would you claim the kingdom? Those who are aware of this will come and claim their inheritance from the father. This is why only a handful out of multi-millions are remembered. There shouldn't be any doubt about anything. We also have the custom and system of offering bhog that has no connection with the knowledge or remembrance. You have no connection with anything else. There are just 2 things, alpha or beta. The kingdom, God is called Alpha. People point upward with their finger to remember Him. It is the soul that points. The Father says, you remember me on the path of devotion. All of you are my lovers. You also know that Baba comes every cycle and liberated all human beings from their sorrow and gives them peace and happiness. This is why Baba has told you to put up a board on which it is written, come and understand how the unlimited Father is establishing peace in this world. If you want to understand how to become a master of the world for 21 births in a second. Come here and understand. Put up a board outside your home. You can open the greatest hospital and university on just 3 feet of land. By having remembrance, you become free from disease for 21 births. And through this study, you receive the sovereignty of heaven. Even the subject say that they will become the masters of heaven. Today, because human beings are residents of hell, they are ashamed. They themselves say, our father has become a resident of heaven and now we are therefore residents of hell. When we die, we will go to the heaven. This is such an easy matter. They say of someone who accomplished one good task that he was a special person or a great donor and that he has now gone to heaven. However, no one can go there yet. When a play ends, everyone comes and stands on the stage. This war will take place when all the actors have arrived here. Then everyone will return home. The wedding procession of Shiva has been remembered. All souls will return with Shubhapa. The main thing is that your 84 births are now ending. The shoe now has to be discarded. Just as a snake sheds its old skin and takes a new one, you will have a new skin, like, for example, body in the golden age. Shri Krishna is so beautiful. He has so much attraction. He has a first-class body. We will have received such body. You say, I will become Narayan. This skin is decayed and dirty. I will shed this and go to the new world. Since you say that you are becoming Narayan from a human being, why don't you remember this and experience happiness? Understand the story of the true Narayan very well. Demonstrate this by putting what you say into practice. Your deeds should be equal to your words. Carry on with your business, etc. But the father says, let your hands do the work whilst your heart remains in the remembrance of the father. The more knowledge you imbibe, the more value it will place on it. You become so wealthy by imbibing this knowledge. This is spiritual knowledge. Your souls, it is a soul that speaks through a body. It is a soul that gives knowledge and it is a soul that imbibes knowledge. Acha. To the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste to the spiritual father. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. S is for Dharna. First point. Even whilst having to see the old things of this old world, don't see them. In order to become Narayan from an ordinary human being, make your deeds equal to your works. Second point, value these imperishable jewels of knowledge. This income you are earning is so huge, never yawn or nod off. In order to remain safe from the bad omen of being attracted to someone's name and form, make effort to stay in remembrance. Blessing. May you become a constant embodiment of success by experiencing being a companion and a detached observer. Once again, may you become a constant embodiment of success by experiencing being a companion and a detached observer. Description: the children who constantly stay with the father automatically become detached observer because the father himself plays his part as a detached observer. Therefore, those who stay with him would also play their parts as detached observer. And those who have the Almighty Authority Father as their companion automatically become embodiments of success. On the path of devotion, they call out to experience his company for a short time and to have a glimpse of him, but you have become his companion in all relationships. Therefore, maintain the happiness and intoxication that you have attained what you wanted to attain. Slogan: the sign of wasteful thoughts is a sad mind and happiness disappearing. The sign of wasteful thoughts is a sad mind and happiness disappearing. Om Shanti. One minute we will remember to our Supreme Soul, Shiv Baba.
निहारने को दिल ये चाहता है, प्रभु को निहारने को दिल ये चाहता है, मन में उतारने को तुम सामने हमारे, तुम साथ में